Hello students. Today, before we start up with our class, I want to pose certain situations to you and you have to tell me how you are going to react to such situation. Here, there is nothing right or wrong. So honestly, try to answer that. Look at this case one. Here, there was a person who was sailing the boat and there were around 40 people, 30 to 40 people who were traveling in that boat. All of a sudden, the boat started sinking. So now the captain had to all of a sudden call for the lifeboat. But the problem was that the lifeboat can only take 7 people. But the people who were traveling in that boat were 30. So the captain had 2 options. Either the captain can throw some overboard people and can save the life of some. And the second option is, don't throw anyone. So what will happen? Some will die automatically. Now let's see the second case, hen's dilemma. There was a man whose name was Hens. He was happily married. One day he recognized that his wife is at the third stage of cancer. He really wanted his wife to survive. So he went to the doctor. And doctor said, yes, we can save the life of your wife. There is a new drug which has been discovered. If you get that drug, we can save your wife's life. Hens rushed to the druggist and he asked for the medicine. Druggist said, I will give you that medicine for 2,000 rupees. Hens didn't have that much money. So he pleaded that druggist, please give me for 1,000 rupees. I don't have that much money. But druggist said, no, I have discovered that. I will not give you less than 2,000. So what did Hens do? At night, Hens broke into his shop and had stolen that drug and saved his wife's life. Students, what do you think? What Hens did, was it right? He should have done that stealing part or he could have avoided that part. Think over it. I'll get back to you. So students, in our life, we get such dilemmas to do or not to do. So these are nothing but our moral dilemmas or our ethical dilemmas. So to describe this, Kohlberg has given his theory of moral development. So in today's class, you will be introduced to the Kohlberg's theory of moral development. We'll be learning about the Kohlberg's 6 stages of moral maturity. And at the end, we'll talk about the criticism on the theory. So what are the objectives of this lesson? That is, explain Kohlberg's theory of moral development, discuss Kohlberg's 6 stages of moral maturity, discuss criticism on Kohlberg's theory of moral development. So students, Kohlberg theory is known as theory of moral reasoning. This is a stage theory. According to Kohlberg, every one of us in our life goes through these stages and we don't skip any stage. And he talked about a very interesting fact that there are 2 aspects. One is moral thinking and one is moral action. Many a time we think morally, but when it comes to action, we find it difficult to do. So people may have a very high moral thinking standard, but when it comes to action, it may differ. According to this theory, people cannot understand moral reasoning more than one stage ahead of their own. What does it mean? It means that whatever stage you are at, you cannot go beyond that stage. You won't be able to understand the theory or the logic behind it. Now let's talk about Kohlberg's 6 stages of moral maturity. First is pre-conventional morality, which consists of 2 sub-stages, that is obedience-punishment orientation, personal reward orientation. Second is conventional morality, which has again 2 sub-stages, good boy, good girl orientation, the law and order orientation. The third main stage is post-conventional morality, which has again 2 sub-stages, social contract orientation and conscience or conscious orientation. Now let's talk about pre-conventional morality. It has a first stage, that is obedience punishment orientation, which talks about right and wrong determined by rewards and punishment. Here the child is deferred to his punishment. Their behavior is based on the consequence of any activity. So whatever leads to punishment, they consider it is wrong. For example, a child does not cheat in a game with his brother because he thinks if the brother will come to know that he's cheating on the game, he may not play with him or he may punish him. Similarly, reward, the right way to behave is the way that is rewarded. Now let's talk about the second stage, that is conventional morality. Here the child start seeking for the social acceptance and they avoid blame. They want approval of others. That is, they want to portray their good behavior. They want to termed as good boy, good girl. You must have seen in schools, you know, kids, they try to make their teachers or other members happy because they want to be known as good boy, good girl, because they want to confirm it and they want that good behavior is being portrayed. So in that only there is a fourth stage, which is known as obedience to authority. Here the person simply obey the rules. He simply follow his duty because he want to settle into the system. He does not want any problem for him. So he simply keep on following the rules and regulation of the system. It may happen that the person may see some flaws in the system, but he will not object to it. So he simply follows it. Now let's talk about the third and the last stage, which is known as post-conventional morality. This is a more evolved stage where the person grow to the abstract notion of justice, rights of others, can override the obedience to law and rules. Now again, I will take back to the hence dilemma later on. Let's first try to understand the stages. Stage 5, here which says the difference between moral and legal right. Recognition that rules should sometimes be broken. Here the child or the person, you know, critically evaluate or examine the society rules and he may decide which are the rules which I should go for, and if he finds that some rules which are not right to do, he may leave those. Sixth stage, individual principle of conscience. This is considered to be the highest stage in moral development and every one of should strive for that. Here the person does not think about himself or herself. Here they follow the universal principles, moral values like brotherhood, peace, cooperation. So that, now again, as I've told you, I'll take back you to the hence dilemma where he has talked about, you know, he was ready to steal because the importance of life was more important than stealing. So at that stage, he was not following that law and order. He was in this stage where the life of value was very important. So now let's talk about the criticism of this theory. Like, as every theory has undergone for some criticism, similar with this also. So first point is androcentric. Here the psychologist said that Kohlberg didn't consider the difference of moral development between males and female. It may happen that male and female may be different at different levels. Poor research design. Here Kohlberg did research on 79 students that were boys, and based on that he came up with his theory. So people felt that it was not a very good research which he has undertaken. Third is hypothetical dilemma, which the example which I had given you about that hence who had stolen the drug. So all those things were hypothetical. Similarly, he took many hypothetical cases and based on that, he evolved different stages. But in reality, how people may react to different situations, that was not considered. Thank you.